Traycraft began in 1979 when a group of Christians got together to try and put into practice the principles of fair trade and justice throughout the world. Their aim is to buy from producers in small local cooperatives or employed by companies who pay wages above the national average or the average for their locality, and who provide other welfare assistance to the people in the community. They also need the products to be commercially viable so that they can expand into other markets if they want to. Park Lane first got involved in August 1985. The turnover at first was small. In fact, at the end of the second year of trading, we got a letter from Tradecraft saying, did we still want to continue, because our sales were below £500 a year. We decided to continue, and the following year doubled sales to £1,000, and this year we're hoping that we'll reach £2,000 by August and the end of our financial year. The goods come from all over the world, from lots of different countries, from small community groups and from larger ones. The tea and the coffee obviously come from larger estates and organisations. The instant coffee is processed in the country of origin so that the greater benefit goes to the people of that country. Some of the tea comes from Tanzania, some comes from India. There are estates there set up to help Tamils who've returned from Sri Lanka to India and who need work and employment. Some of the crafts come from small groups who have moved to the cities, the people who have moved from a rural economy, gone to the cities to try and find work to support their families, and then find there's no employment for them. And in India in particular, a large proportion of the urban population is in fact employed in very small businesses in local areas. And Tradecraft tries to buy from such groups where the money will go directly to the people who have done the work. Tradecraft also deal in recycled paper, the aim being to cut down on the number of trees that are being felled in order to make paper. They use pre- and post-consumer waste and produce a wide variety of products, from toilet rolls and kitchen rolls to fancy stationery. Food is also one of Tradecraft's big sellers. They do a variety of things, from nuts to dried fruit to coconut, and even import sweets made from sugar in Cuba. In Bangladesh, a large number of jute products are produced, hemp twine for garden and other use, bags, decorations, the traditional seekers that we so often see. And Tradecraft buy quite a number of these. At the time of the floods last year and the previous year, Tradecraft's immediate response was to pay in advance a double the amount that they would normally have paid, so that the craft workers there, while struggling to restore their homes and get going again, knew that they had some income from their crafts in advance and could immediately get working again to buy in the raw materials and to be able to work rather than just have to wait and wait until their homes were better, until they had the facilities and the resources. And so Tradecraft tries to help its producers not just by taking benefit for itself, but on looking at their needs as well. Recently, Tradecraft has also been producing more clothes. This is the third year of having a major clothing collection, and the product and the presentation has improved each year.